Hi, my name is Gaurish and welcome to Salesforce Rangers. Today we are going to discuss about Apex Map. In our previous video, we talked about some basics and some method get and put of maps. But today we are going to go into some details like creating maps and creating complex type of maps. So let's start with a trigger. So I have a requirement which says calculate total amount of all opportunities under an account. Now we know that the relationship between account and opportunity is of parent to child. Account is parent and opportunity is child. We can have more than one opportunities under an account. Now the requirement is to roll up the amount of all opportunities on the account. We can accomplish this requirement by roll up summary field and by simpler ways, but in order to explain map, I'm going to show you the hard way. So I'm gonna loop my trigger.new in trigger.new. I will have all the opportunities which I'm inserting in one go, and in our example, let's talk about consider that we are inserting six opportunities: OPP1, OPP2, and OPP6, up to OPP6. Now OPP1 belongs to account 1, OPP2 belongs to account 1, and OPP3 belongs to another account, which is account 2. OPP4 belongs to account 2. OPP5 belongs to account 3. And OPP6 belongs to another account, which is account 4. We are considering this. So for account A1, we have two opportunities. For account A2, we have two opportunities. And for A3 and A4, we have one opportunity. Now what we need to do, we need to create a map, and by using that map we need to identify that this account is having these opportunities. So we are going to create a map of ID, in which we are going to put account ID and a list of opportunity, which is our value. So for one account ID, we will have list of opportunity, which may or may not have more than one opportunity. So let's map it ACC OPP map. Now we talked about the put method. We will put OPP dot account ID and since the value is of list of opportunity type, so we will have to first instantiate that list. That list does not exist yet. So we will write like this: list new list of opportunity, and it's a blank list. So after writing this statement, what will happen when OPP1, the loop iterates on OPP1, we will put A1 as the account ID and we will have a blank list of opportunity. Now when OPP2 will come, it will again put account ID A1 and again creates a blank list. So it's not going to work. We will have to put an if condition, and we will only create this blank list here when our map does not contain a particular account ID as the key. So we will check ACC OPP map dot contains key OPP dot account ID, and I will put a not operator here. So this if condition will only work if there is a new account coming. Then only we are going to create a blank list for that new account. But the question arises that what's the benefit of having the new list? We should add something to it. So we are going to use the map again and use the get method and use the same account ID. What it will return? It will return this blank list which we have just put in this line. So this statement is going to return me the blank list. Now the list has a method called add, and we are going to add an opportunity to that blank list. So what does it, how does it work? I am going to go into the details of it now. So OPP1 is coming at first. Right now our map is blank. So OPP.AccountID, which is A1, does not exist in the map. That's why it is going to put A1 and a blank list. And in the second line, it's going to use the get method. And what we will get? We will get a blank list, which we just put on line number 6. And we will add OPP1. So in our map, we have A1, OPP1. Now, in the second iteration, OPP2 is there. OPP2 has the same account as the OPP1. So this if condition is not going to be executed now. I mean this one, because this condition is will not be satisfied. So we will, you know, directly jump to line number 8 and we will our map will return this list which has OPP1 already, and in that list we are going to add OPP2. So this becomes OPP2. Now when OPP3 comes, A2 is not there in our map. So if condition is going to be executed this time, and for A2 there will be another key value pair for A2 which is a blank list at this line. Now on the line number 8, we are going to put a OPP3 in that blank list. OPP3 will be there, and when OPP4 comes, A2 is already there. So this if condition is not going to be executed, and we will directly jump to line number 8, and we are just going to add OPP4 like we did earlier. After that comes OPP5, which has a new account which is A3, and A3 does not exist in our map. So it's going to put another key value pair A3 comma blank list, and in that blank list we are going to add OPP. So OPP file 5 will be added here. Then OPP6 comes into the picture in the iteration, and it's going to put another key value pair similarly as OPP5. OPP6 will be there. So this is how, you know, we are combining the parent and the list of child. See, if you understand this logic, then I think you 50% of map is covered. You will be able to, you know, by doing some practice, you will be able to understand it completely. Now what we are going to do, we are going to fetch our accounts, ACC list, select ID from account where ID in ACC OPP map dot keyset. Since my map keyset contains all the account IDs, that's why I am using my map dot keyset. So I am fetching all the accounts which are existing, you know, in our map keyset. Now I am going to iterate on this list. Account ACC, ACC list, and I will write list of opportunity. Now I need to get the list of opportunity for this account. So since we had four type of accounts, A1, A2, A3, A4, so this list is going to return me A1, A2, A3, A4, and this for loop is going to execute four times for our scenario. OPP list. Now I will use my map to get the opportunity list for this particular account. Our map name is ACC OPP map dot get. Now what should I pass in my map? I will pass only that thing which I have put in my map, and what I have put account ID. So I'm gonna write ACC dot ID. If I am not putting it correctly, if I am putting something and getting it from something else, then my map is not going to work. You know, sometimes there is a question arise when we are learning this thing, that how should we know that what to put in my map? And this thing is only going to come when you are practicing it enough. So by giving it the account ID, I am gonna get my opportunity list, and I will then iterate on my opportunity list again. I have created a total amount variable, and I will roll up the amount field of opportunity, and I can assign this total amount field in the account custom field. Suppose I have created a custom field which I have not total amount. Now I will write it like this. So this total amount will be calculated by summing up all the opportunities amount, and we will be rolling it up to the account, and then we can update our ACC list so that it updates all the accounts total amount field. Now it is showing an error because we don't have this custom field, obviously. Let's delete it and save it. So that is how we use map in Apex. Map is a very powerful collection, and it takes some time. Do not get demotivated if you are not getting a grasp on maps. You will need a lot of practice, just practice it, and you can comment if you have any doubts. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.